Hello 12th class, welcome to English Kaksha again. Today we are going to read your next poem, A Thing of Beauty, that is beautifully penned by a famous poet, John Keats. John Keats is also known as a romantic poet and a lover of nature. In this poem also he tries to explain how a beautiful thing is a joy forever and the loveliness of a beautiful thing never pass or fades away. Even though when we look at them, it increases the beauty day after day. So we will enjoy the poem and we will see that beautiful objects that the poet has mentioned in this poem. So let's start the poem. A Thing of Beauty is a poem that is written by John Keats. First we will read about the poet. John Keats was an English romantic poet. He was one of the main poets of second generation of romantic poets. His writing is characterized by sensual imagery and contains many poetic devices. Now we will see what is given in this poem. In this poem, the poet tries to explain how a beautiful thing is a joy forever. He has described the influences made by beautiful things and calls them endless fountain of immortal drink. Right? Now we will read lines 1 to 5 first. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health, and quiet breathing. A thing of beauty is a joy forever means always, right? Its loveliness means beauty. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower. Bower means a shady place, under trees, or you can say a pleasant place where we can get happiness. Quiet means silent. A sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Now we will see what is given in these lines. Here the poet says that a thing of beauty can be a permanent source of joy or happiness. Its loveliness never fades from our imagination. Rather it increases because our imagination adds new colors to it. It never passes into nothingness. It always remains fresh in our memory. It serves the purpose of a quiet bower for us. We can move into this bower whenever we like. In other words, in the moment of sadness, we can recall the beauty of the object and can feel happy again. Its memory will lead us to a gentle sleep of sweet dreams, and it will keep us healthy and give us all peace. ऐसा होता है ना कि जब हम कोई सुंदर चीज़ देख लें और बार बार हम उसको याद करें, अगर हम उदास फील कर रहे हैं तो अचानक से फिर हमें दोबारा खुशी महसूस होती है, राइट? और अगर हम उसे याद करते करते सोते हैं तो हम बहुत अच्छे तरीके से नींद ले सकते हैं और हमें बड़ी शांति फील होती है. इन द सेम वे द पॉइंट इज सेइंग दैट अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी इज अ जॉय फॉरएवर. नाउ वी विल सी लाइन्स 6 to 13. देयरफॉर ऑन एवरी मोरो वी आर रीडिंग अ फ्लावरी बैंड टू बाइंड अस टू द अर्थ. Spite of despondence, of the inhumid dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways, made for our searching, yes, in spite of all, some shapes of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. First we will see the meanings of the words. Therefore on every morrow, morrow means morning, the next day after the present day, right? Reading. Wreathing means covering. Flowery band. Flowery band means strip of flowers. Phoolo ki ladi. Spite of. Spite of means in spite of. In spite of means kisi cheez ke bawajood. Right? Despondence. Despondence means loss of hope. Inhuman dearth means terrible shortage. Noble natures. Noble natures means nice people. People of having noble hearts. Over darkened ways, that is very mysterious things or happenings. Made for our searching, yes, in spite of all, some shapes of beauty moves away the pearl. Pearl means moments, or you can say the some shapes of beauty, some beautiful things. Pearl means coffin or coffin. Dark spirits, sad or dejected heart, right? So now we will see what is given in these lines.
Here the poet says that it is beauty alone that keeps us going on this earth. Beauty is a kind of flowery band. Here it is given, it is a flowery band. Beauty is a kind of flowery band that binds us to this earth. इसी चीज ने हमें इस धरती से जोड़ा हुआ है. It is beauty that keeps us moving from one day to the next day. There is so much to grieve in the world. But for beauty, it would be impossible to live here. वैसे इस दुनिया में रहना बहुत मुश्किल हो जाए अगर दुख और दर्द हो और ब्यूटी ना हो. Right? So, spite of despondence of human dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, here what is given? The poet says that there is depression and dejection. Despondence, depression and dejection all around. There is depression and dejection all around. There are very few people who have a really noble heart. And man's life is full of gloom or gloomy. There are many mysterious happenings that man fails to understand in spite of all his attempts. But in spite of these means the unhappy things. In spite of all these unhappy things, man continues to live on this earth. It is the beauty of these objects that takes away the gloom from our heart or from our dejected hearts, sad hearts, right? Now we will read lines 13 to 19. Such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon. For simple sheep and such are daffodils, that for themselves a cooling covert make, against the hot season, the mid-forest break. Let's see the words first. Such, such means of this type. Sprouting, sprouting means producing. Simple sheep means innocent-hearted sheep. Then is daffodils. Daffodils means flowers. Then covert. Covert means a hiding place or covered shelter for animals. Break. Break means thicket. Thicket, the thick bushes. That is called thickest. Let's see what is given in these lines. Actually here, the poet list out or pick out some of the beautiful things that add beauty to the sad hearts on this earth. He says that there are beautiful sun and the moon. There are big and small trees that gives pleasant shade for the gentle sheep. And then there are lovely daffodils with all the green world in which they live. Green world means the green area that is around the flowers. There are clear streams that make cooling covert along their course to protect themselves from the hot season. Here, with the flowers, there are little streams or rills, chhoti nadiyan behti hain, jo aas paas un phoolon ko thandak deti hain. Right? And then there are low-lying plants in the middle of the forest with the lovely white roses growing among here and there. Fine? Now we will see lines 20 to 24. Rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose. Sprinkling means scattered. जैसे हम किसी चीज का छिड़काव कर देते हैं, that is called sprinkling. Musk rose. Musk rose means scented flower. And blooms. Blooms is also flowers. So what is given here? Here in this line, the poet says that the beauty has been enhanced. Beauty को बढ़ा दिया गया है. कैसे? By a sprinkling of blooming musk roses. जैसे इधर उधर खुशबूदार scented flowers को फैला दिया गया है. Right? And such too is the grandeur of dooms. Dooms means the final judgment day of God. We have imagined for the mighty dead all lovely tales that we have heard or read. An endless fountain of immortal drink. Immortal drink means nectar, जिसे आप अमृत बोलते हो, right? Mighty dead means great heroes. Mighty dead, great heroes. And then comes pouring onto us from the heaven's brink. Heaven's brink. Brink means border or edge. Swarg ka kinara, right? Now we will see what is given in these lines. कॉन्टिन्यूइंग विद द लिस्ट ऑफ ब्यूटिफुल थिंग्स, जब वो सुंदर सुंदर चीज़ों को बता रहा है तो पोइट क्या कहता है, द पोइट सेज दैट वी इमेजिन मैग्निफिशेंट रिवॉर्ड्स बाय गॉड ऑन द डे ऑफ जजमेंट फॉर दोज माइटी मैन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हु आर नाउ लाइंग डेड इन देयर ग्रेव्स. कहने का मतलब है उस अंतिम निर्णय के दिन ईश्वर उन शक्तिशाली लोगों के लिए सुंदर पुरस्कार की कल्पना करता है और जो जो मर चुके हैं और वो कब्र के अंदर हैं. राइट, अगेन ही थिंक्स दैट दोज ग्रैंड रिवार्ड्स एंड आर फिल्ड विद हैप्पीनेस. देन देर आर लवली टेल्स ऑफ ओल्डन डेज दैट वी हैव हर्ड और रेड. द पोएट कॉल्स ऑल दीज ब्यूटीज एंड एंडलेस फाउंटेन ऑफ इमॉर्टल ड्रिंक दैट हैवन इटसेल्फ इज पोरिंग डाउन फॉर अस. इन अदर वर्ड्स, गॉड हिमसेल्फ हैज क्रिएटेड दीज ब्यूटिफुल थिंग्स फॉर अस दैट वी कैन डिराइव जॉय फ्रॉम विच वी कैन ड्राइव. ड्राइव मीन्स ले लेते हैं, जिनसे हम खुशी ले लेते हैं. एंड देन दे कैन गिव अस मच जॉय एज एंजल्स ड्राइव फ्रॉम इमॉर्टल ड्रिंक ऑफ हेवन. जैसे फरिश्ते स्वर्ग में अमृत को पी के खुशी महसूस करते हैं, ऐसे ही हम भगवान की बनाई हुई इन चीज़ों को देख कर खुशी महसूस करते हैं. राइट, सो दैट्स वाई ही इज सेइंग दैट द थिंग्स ऑफ ब्यूटी हैव अ डिवाइन प्रेजेंस इन आर लाइफ गिविंग अस अ जॉय. नाउ वी विल सी विच लिटरेरी डिवाइसेज आर यूज इन दिस पोएम. फर्स्ट इज एलिटरेशन. हेयर आई हैव टेकन डिफरेंट वर्ड्स फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट स्टैंजाज. फर्स्ट, एंड अ स्लीप फुल ऑफ स्वीट ड्रीम्स, एस इज रिपीटेड हेयर. बैंड बाइंड बी. Noble nature, N. Sprouting shady, S is repeated. Cooling covert, C. Have heard, H. So in this way, you will find the different words in the different stanzas. And you can easily identify that alliteration is used, right? Next is metaphor. Bower quiet and wreathing a flowery band. Next comes the use of imagery. Imagery is imagination. Here the poet have imagined that all the bushes are full of musk roses. Then books describing valor. Valor means bravery of fighters. God providing us with best things. These are the imagination of the poet. So this is called imagery. One question is there in your book that you will find there. What images does the poet use to describe the beautiful bounty of the earth? These words can be taken as an answer. Fine. Next is antithesis. Antithesis, what is antithesis? Antithesis means where the opposite words are used together, like old and young. Fine. Rhyme scheme. Which rhyme scheme is used in the poem? In the whole poem, we are having one consistent rhyming scheme, that is AA, BB, C. Right? For this is from this poem, A Thing of Beauty. I think you have enjoyed the poem very much. Thank you.